today I am doing this tutorial for you right here. This is a super fun doll look that you could totally rock for Halloween. So, yeah. Now, I did voice over some of what you're about to hear. Reason being is just, it was easier, straight up. So, there you go. So, basically, I kind of already did some stuff. I was just messing around, and I kind of liked how it turned out, so I wanted to film the other half. The only part that you missed was I did apply a full coverage of foundation. Go a little bit lighter than your skin tone if you're able to. I'm already pretty pale, so it was hard without going to pure white. But I used a full coverage, so I used the Studio Gear Matte Foundation, and I mixed that with the white face and body from MAC. So all I did was just mix that here on a palette, and then I went ahead and I applied that all over the face, and I set that with a white setting powder from MAC, and I used their Prep and Prime. It's just a transparent powder. And then I did it again. So liquid foundation, this on top, powder, powder, powder. And it's best to apply the powder with the sponge. You just get a more even tone. Then I put liquid foundation on again using the sponge and then the powder. So it's two steps. That's how you get like a completely full, ridiculously full coverage. So I went ahead and did that. I also filled in or covered my eyebrows a little bit, and I just did that using a glue stick and then foundation. There's so many videos out there on how to do it, so, you know, just go ahead and apply that. And this part, as far as what I did, I went in with some white underneath. The first thing that I used was actually from this Makeup Forever palette, and I went ahead with this white shade right here, and I used that just to kind of make the shape underneath the eye, and I also covered all my lashes because we need that part to be white. So that just kind of gives the shape. So that's where you can play with it. Make it as big as you want, as small as you want. Make it, you know, whatever you want to do. Just do that with the white. And I went ahead and set that with a little bit of a white eyeshadow, which is right here. And that's from Inglot. Just completely matte white. And then just to outline, we're going to add to it later, but just to give me an idea of how the shape was going to look, I went in with a black pencil, which I set somewhere. Oh, right here. This is from Studio Gear Cosmetics. It's just a black. I went in and I kind of traced underneath where the white and just really briefly right on top of here, okay? And you are going to want to use primer or something to set this so that you can get the full look. So, that's basically where we are now. Cover everything. Oh, cover your lips and everything too because we'll get to that. And then now I'll show you the next steps. First, go ahead and take that bright purple color. It's called Flash and it's from Urban Decay Cosmetics. Take a small brush and use it to outline the area where you're going to put the purple. So I'm just basically taking it directly underneath my eyebrow and bringing it down by the white and doing the same on top of that area. And once that's finished, completely fill the area in, blending the edges, and do the same thing underneath your eye down by where the white is. Bright blue color. It's called Peace, also from Urban Decay Cosmetics, and completely fill in the lid area. So anywhere that you have skin, make sure you fill it in. And then grab a brow pencil. Anyone will work. I'm just using one from Clinique, and use that to map out where you want to put the brows. Now using vanilla pigment, I'm going to take that and add my highlight directly on top of the purple flash color. And here's a little trick. Take a foundation brush that still has the foundation on it. And this is going to give you a nice straight line by that area. So just kind of pull it up and blend it out. Now for the brows, take a brow powder and just kind of fill it in. Again, this just helps to map the area out. Go ahead and line your top line. I'm using the Studio Gear Black Onyx Gel Liner. And use the same color for the brows. So since you already have it mapped out, you're basically just coloring and tracing directly on top. That same gel liner, go ahead and go over that line that we previously had under the white. Now lashes, I'm using the MAC lashes number 2, and these other lashes are number 41 that I got from iMats. I'm applying glue to the MAC lashes and just kind of let it chill. Now bronze, I'm using the Studio Gear Matte Bronzer, and you really want to use a lot of bronzer if you notice. So bring it up by the hairline, really in on the cheeks, down and completely under the chin. You really want to chisel the face out. For a blush, I'm using MAC Alpha Girl, and you really want to apply it to get that nice pink color. Now for the lashes, I slowed it down so you guys can really see what's going on. Take the lashes, apply it like you normally would do falsies, except you want to extend it out. So really follow that line that you had previously drawn, otherwise the whole look is off. So really make sure it's on, press it on there really well, and once it's applied, go ahead and take your finger and kind of roll it across the top of the lashes. When you do that, that really helps to keep the lashes up and brighter. Back with the gel liner, use that to do your upper waterline, really filling it in, and you can also apply it to any lashes that aren't dark enough. Use mascara, doesn't matter which one. Now for the bottom lashes, slowing it down again, you really want to apply it again to that outer edge, making sure that the lashes actually touch one another. Hold the lashes really gently and slightly pull it over. This can be a little difficult if you've never done lower lashes before. Follow that line that we had before, the black, and once it's completely pressed in, take your fingers and squeeze the outer edges together just like that, and that will actually connect the two lashes. Some primer to touch up your lower lashes. Now I'm taking a liner. This is Flesh from Ulta. It's the color of my lips just to kind of outline the shape. I already have a porcelain doll shape to my lips, so I'm kind of just tracing over that, making it a little bit smaller. The color that I'm using there is called More to Love from MAC. And that's a lip liner just to apply back over the area that I've already mapped out. And now I'm going to take it and kind of fill in the corners. That way it just darkens it a little bit and gives it a little bit more of a shape. Lip color I'm using is called Candy Yum Yum. Just apply that and fill that in the lip area. And the gloss I'm using, Dazzle Gloss, it's called Extra Amps. And you really want to apply a good amount of gloss on. So this is the finalized look. Ta-da! I actually dig it. I hope you liked it. I had a lot of fun doing it. And this is just a wig that I had from like years ago. As you can see, it's not in the best shape. But just to give you an idea, you can totally throw it on with something. The only thing that I added that you didn't see in the recording was this mole. So to do that, just go ahead and take some gel liner on a brush and dip in the gel liner, dip it on your skin, and just do a little twist and you're done. So this is just to show you one way that you could totally wear it. To be honest, I think it looks pretty amazing with the pink hair. So that way at least you have options. But again, this is everything. So I hope you liked it. If you have any questions or anything, of course, go ahead and let me know. And I will see you guys next time. Bye, guys.